Father, we pause at this time to give you thanks for all the many blessings you have showered down on us. We just ask for your guidance in everything we say and do this evening. We ask for your guidance as we do the people's business. Just be with us and help us do the right thing. In your holy name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Bill. This time we'll call the first meeting of April 2012's County Commission together. Thank you all for being here. Didn't want to report Tim Sutton is not going to be with us tonight. He has a personal situation he's dealing with. He was not at the budget retreat either this morning. Commissioners, if you'll take a look at the agenda, and if there are any items that you would like to add or rearrange, and at the same time review the consent agenda, we'll entertain a motion for the approval of the agenda, which will include the items on the consent agenda. Is there such a motion?
So moved.
Thank you, Bill. Okay. Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Thank you. We don't have any public comments tonight, so we don't have any early commissioner responses. The first item of business tonight is the lottery fund request from the school system. I'd like to welcome Mr. W.D. Yarborough, who's in charge of facilities with the school system. W.D., welcome to you.
Chairman Manning, board members, appreciate y'all letting me come in front of you tonight. We'd like to request the use of lottery money for y'all to approve use of lottery money, and then I'll just open it up for questions if y'all got any questions about what we got on that sheet that was handed to you.
W.D., for the benefit of the folks that are perhaps listening in or tuning in later, okay, can you just summarize the total kind of by category like you presented to us here?
Okay. What we've got going is the total will be a little over $3 million, and it's in five different categories. The first one is asbestos. This $800,000 that we have on here should finish up at the Williams High School project where we've been taking out of Williams High School for the last four summers. The carpet, this goes to the schools that are about 20, 22 years old. I know Smith and Hillcrest look like new schools, but they're actually 20 years old, and that's where the replacement goes on that. The ADA elevator will go to Newland, Andrews, and Grove Park, same way with age to rework those. Painting, that's to go throughout a lot of different schools, not a total paint of all schools. It's go in and touch up where it's needed to most. And then the lighting down at the bottom is, I guess y'all are aware of that as of July, you will no longer be able to get the type of light bulb that you see above you, the T12. So we're looking about switching over from T12s, T8s, plus electronic ballast for energy savings. And the total of that would come to the figure you see down on the bottom of the page of $3,065,000.
I asked WD before the meeting, lottery has been good for Alamance County and for Alamance County schools. The work you see here is basically repair, renovation, upfitting expenses. However, since we have entered into the lottery, we have completed 16 classrooms.
18 classrooms, yes, sir.
Four different schools.
Yes, sir.
This year alone, classrooms were completed at AO Elementary and Western Middle. Mm-hmm. The very first expansion was at B. Everett Jordan.
Yes, sir.
And then when you moved to Sylvan.
Correct.
In the meantime, we've gotten other expenses. So it really has been good for us. The lottery funds from the state can go into building needs, technology needs. I think now it's been expanded to providing lower classroom sizes.
Correct.
By
Correct.
Teacher supplemental Correct. Pay. And it seems like there was one more area.
It's
either pre-K or some funding.
Actually, teacher funded, too. It can fund
teacher funded teacher for?
Not just pre-K, I think some teacher positions, too.
For any certified mm-hmm. position. Mm-hmm. So it has been good. Clyde, you've tracked the lottery ins and outs over the time as far as what has come into the county and what has gone out.
Craig has.
Well, that's the first time I've ever looked at Clyde and he went, no.
Clyde's saying we was tracking it, but not for that reason.
I guess one of the clarifications, if you don't mind, we were needing, and we were looking at the applications that were here that were for $350,000. or is it for how much is?
No, it should be for $3 million if you total all of them up. If you got all the applications down here, it should be for $3 million. Do you have the sheet of paper that's?
Yeah, we have that, but the applications that list it by school totals
right.
up to 350.
If it is,
1,631.
If it is, somebody has pulled one of the applications out of there. And I'll be glad to look at see which one was pulled out.
Because I guess, have you looked at the balance of what, because again.
If we spend the money that's on the sheet now, the 300, we will still have in excess of 1 million, I think it's like 1,000,001 left in lottery.
Well, but we have a, is that taken into account the county's
it
drawdown?
Is. It's taken into account of that. Now, I'll speak it off the top of my head. Remember, we pay, I think it's about $1.5 million each year for the next 15 years for the stimulus
right.
project we got
right.
for the Career Tech Center. Right. So if you even collect that, we were showing that we had like a little over $1 million left after this.
Well, again, there's two drawdowns that the county has to do this year for $2 million. And then we were going to do an additional $1 million next year to cover some shortfalls from the sales tax, but also for the career tech as well. So again, the applications we got here are $350,000. It's not the $3 million that
oh, yeah. yeah, that's a whole lot of difference.
Yeah.
I can't address that because I don't know what you've got in front of you. I know that our supposedly finance director has talked with y'all's finance
right.
director, and supposedly we had that worked
right.
out. So I,
Mr. Chair, if it's agreeable with the board, maybe we could table this. And again, I do apologize. Again, we were going off applications that
well,
we saw.
Well, now that's fine. If I can just bring one thing to the board, if we table it, the lottery meets they meet on April the 25th, and if it's not to them before, I think it's the second week of this month, then they wouldn't be able to vote on it April 25th. Which isn't any problem. It's just that we wouldn't be able to do these projects you see on that sheet
during the summer.
Yeah, during this summer, they were trying to get all this done. And I understand, I'm the first to say if it's $3 million off, I'm the first to say that.
So well, these what? Applications were supposed to add up to the $3
million? Yes, ma'am, you should have. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Well, we got the cover sheet that has $3,000,063.
Yeah, we got the cover sheet.
I don't know what the application are, but everything that was on that cover sheet should.
Right, there's. And that's where we came up with the 350
right.
for
right.
the application.
And I apologize for that because I don't know where that's. That's in my department.
We should have clarified right. this before this evening.
And you got to have it to them by when? Because we have another meeting.
Yeah, our next meeting will be the 16th.
16th.
Yeah. Well, let me ask a question, Craig. If the summary here, and I. Amy, you have that summary
right,
statement,
yeah.
and that totals $3,063,000. Is that correct?
That's correct.
And what we're saying is the individual applications, we don't have them for all these different schools. We have a sample. Is that right?
Well, we have applications that total up to $350,000.
Right, and my question is, those applications, if we can match those up to here, what I'm wondering is if for some reason the individual applications did not get copied with the summary.
Right.
All of them did not. And my question is, if that's the case, and we can rely on this cover page to consider and vote, then we can get the individual applications. For instance, let's just look at one.
Well, what Craig said, though,
there may be a
shortfall.
We've got
to do some math here
first. We've got to make sure that.
Right.
With respect to the drawdowns that have already been.
We're going to have enough to do what we have to do.
Well. You said it would take over a period of 5 years.
Oh, yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. That's what I'm saying.
This could be what they're currently drawing
that
this fiscal year.
Right. Because I know that the asbestos, I just got a tally on asbestos. It's around $250,000. This would do it for that. That equals up to what would be asked. And that may be where they were coming from on that one.
Okay. Well, if they could just, I mean, I think it'd be okay, Craig, over
right.
the 5 year period, because they're going to add
right.
to it. But if we could get the amount by fiscal year that you think you'll draw down?
What I would suggest is what they submitted you, the 300 and whatever, if the board would go ahead and approve that, then that's what we would do this summer. That would be, and what, you know, we can come back. Exactly. That's fine, because if that's the application you got now, then that's what they thought that we could probably do this summer. And this was to give y'all what we're doing, planning on doing.
That makes sense. That's overall.
Right.
That's fine with me.
$300,000 is what the.
Whatever you, what is it?
$350,631.17.
$350.
Which should be the sum of the individual applications.
Right, exactly.
Going to sign off.
Yes.
That work for us. Just a shoot here.
All right, do we need to go through the individual schools or not?
I think unless you need the clarification, but as far as the motion, it could be just.
As presented.
Yes, sir.
Okay, is there such a motion?
I'll make a motion that we do the $350,000.
Thank you, I didn't mean to cut you off. Motion by Eddie, second by Bill. Any other discussion or questions? We'll approve the amount that's totaling the $300,000+. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Thank you.
Thanks, sir. And if I'll get back with y'all with it.
Thank you.
Next item, two budget amendments. We heard a little bit about these this morning. Welcome the Honorable Sheriff of Alamance County, Terry Johnson.
Good afternoon, Commissioners. Great to appear before you again today. At least I wasn't the going to commit suicide like y'all made me this morning. I'm appearing before you to ask for a transfer of federal drug seize monies and also state forfeiture drug seize monies to go into equipment line items to help us finish our updating our technical equipment and things that are in need for the Sheriff's Department. For instance, we're in need of 12 in-car MDTs, which is mobile data terminals that's in the cars. We're needing 14 SRT vests, which is expired. Y'all heard me talk today about the expiration date, the liability the county faces. 8 regular duty vests, and we retired 2 canines, and we're asking to be able, out of this federal drug seize monies, to purchase 2 new canines to replace those 2 plus training, 10 in-car video systems, that's the cameras, and 12 tasers. And that will, we're asking that $88,470 be transferred from state federal drug or state drug seize money, and $100,203 in federal drug seize money, which will complete our able to equip all of our frontline vehicles with cameras, mobile data, computer terminals, and our vests and stuff that have been outdated. And if you have any questions.
I asked this morning.
Oh, yeah.
I'm just curious, what causes a vest to get outdated? Is something
there's a date put on for the manufacturer, liability. Once that date expires, and they're usually about 5 years.
But what is it about it that expires?
Well, the material in it. That breaks down, right, and can allow, penetration of a bullet. You know, I'm not a vest expert. I wear them, and I hope they work. That's all I can tell you. We're also transferring in those transfers $19,985 is to the cars we bought, because the equipment does not work, the cages does not work. Transferring from the Crown Vicks to Tahoe or to a Dodge Charger, and we're buying that out of federal drug seize money to the cages and things like that, lights and stuff.
So that covers both budget amendments?
Yes, sir. That covers
122 and 123.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Any questions for the sheriff?
Just one. Now, assuming you may get a car or two next year, okay?
That is assuming.
How much of an issue is it to change your equipment that you're doing, like for your?
Well, business? That's something else we were wanting to, and once again, if we were able, and I'm certainly not throwing this back in anyway, but if we were able to get the 20-some cars we needed, that equipment we could hold off putting that equipment in. And see, it sort of put us in a catch-22 situation, because you have to pay. It's about $600-$700 a car to have that equipment transferred over. If we go on and put it in the ones that don't have it now, and all of a sudden we get were able to get cars, then guess what we got to do? Another $500-$600, take it from that credit. So that's why we sort of wait to see what's going to happen. And with the economy the way it is, I totally understand that. Totally understand it.
I was just curious. I figured it is a cost. Yeah.
It is a cost.
That said, I'll make a motion that we approve this.
I second it.
Thank you, Aiden. Any other discussion or questions? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed?
Thank you very much.
County manager reports.
First, I'd like to thank the staff and also the department heads and also the board for our retreat today. I think we were able to share a lot of good information and get some good feedback from the board. I do appreciate that, and we're going to begin looking at a lot of different options. We did have a request from Commissioner Sutton. He did call today. He does want us to begin to look at formulating options as quickly as possible. So I did tell him I would mention that. Or he talked to Mr. Burgess today, and he wanted me to relay that message to you. So we'll begin looking at options as soon as we can. We do have our luncheon tomorrow with the Farm Bureau. It is at 12 o'clock at Iron Gate Winery. Our meeting with the General Assembly members is scheduled for April 19th at 11 a.m. To 1 at the Family Justice Center, and I think everybody's been confirmed on that. And just a quick reminder, we will be closed Friday for Good Friday, but Monday will be a furlough day for county employees. So that will be a non-paid day for county employees for Easter. And that's all I have at this time.
The Iron Gate is starting at 12 or 11:30? Is it 12?
12.
Is it 12?
Yeah,
I think it's 12. Meet and greet at 11:30. I'm sorry.
So sometime in between.
Yes, sir.
Let me ask you something, Chris.
Yes, sir.
Well, when are we supposed to vote for the ACC bond referendum? Is that they going to present it officially to us, or?
It's probably going to be sometime in May or June,
okay.
I think. So but it is coming.
Is that going to be soon enough to get it on the ballot if we approve it?
Yes, sir. We have worked a tentative schedule with the county attorney and sent it to them. I think they wanted to make sure that right now the focus is making sure we get the budget and maybe not confuse the two at this point.
Any other questions or comments for county manager? Any comments at all? Any announcements? All right, Linda.
What?
Look, stay in your
Thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners meeting. Meetings of the Commissioners Board occur at 7 p.m. on the first and third Monday of each month in the Commissioners' Chambers on the second floor of the County Office Building located at 124 West Elm Street in Graham. Changes to the meeting schedule will be posted on the Commissioners' website at www.alamance-nc.com. You can watch the most recent meeting of the County Commissioners on the second and fourth Wednesday of each month on Time Warner's local public access channel beginning at 10 o'clock p.m. You can also watch recordings of the most recent meeting and past meetings by going to our website at www.alamance-nc.com. Please visit our website for more information on watching commissioner meetings online. For technical questions about this meeting's online or television broadcast, please contact our county webmaster at webmaster@alamance-nc.com. Please note that this address is for technical questions only. Questions or comments regarding the content of commissioner meetings may be made to the commissioners themselves. You can find their contact information at the Alamance County website at www.alamance-nc.com. Click on the link that says Alamance County Commissioners to visit the commissioners' website, where you can learn about our commissioners, read minutes of past meetings, access agendas, and find other information about our Board of Commissioners. You can also send mail correspondence to the County Commissioners by addressing it to the Alamance County Commissioners, 124 West Elm Street, Graham, North Carolina, 27253. Again, thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners meeting.